Hello and welcome to Health Professional Radio. I'm your host, Neil Howard. Thank you so much for joining us for another segment. We're going to be speaking with Mr. Rob Etherington this morning. He's joining us here from Clene Nanomedicine to talk about the company's lead drug candidate, CNM-AU8. He's also going to talk about some phase 2 and 3 studies involving this compound with ALS. Welcome to Health Professional Radio, Rob Etherington. Thank you for taking the time this morning.
Thank you, Neil, for speaking with me.
Well, give us a brief look into your professional background, if you would. Talk about your role at Clene and give us a bit of the company's background.
Certainly. After graduate school, I immediately joined Pfizer Pharmaceuticals. So I had a good experience to work at one of the largest, most well-known pharmaceutical companies for 9 years, during which time I had various roles in the sales and the marketing department, culminating with a key position over the Lipitor franchise, one of the most familiar drugs that many people have heard of, working in the cholesterol arena. Then I joined a very small startup the year we took the company public, a company called Actelion, which many of your listeners maybe have not heard of, but became the largest biotech in Europe, based in Switzerland. We focused on rare orphan diseases, primarily pulmonary arterial hypertension. I had a wonderful experience there for 13 years. That company ended up being sold to Johnson Johnson. And in 2012, I was contacted to see if I would be willing to come over and start another startup, which we've named Clene. We founded Clene in 2013. And our particular focus is developing new treatments for neurodegenerative diseases.
Since you are focused on neurodegenerative diseases, I was going to ask about this lead drug candidate, CNM-AU8. What is it and how does it work?
Certainly. Our treatment, CNM-AU8, is designed to drive critical cellular energy production and utilization reactions in the brain. Now, you and I and the entire human family, we slow down as we get older. There is a reason that neurodegenerative diseases happen in aging. And specifically, we have a large body of preclinical and a growing body of clinical data to support our approach. What our lead drug, CNM-AU8, is doing is driving that cellular energy production and its utilization to enable both neuroprotection and remyelination within the central nervous system. Regarding our clinical data, we recently announced from a phase 2 study we called Rescue ALS, data where we showed clinically meaningful benefits in patients with early amyotrophic lateral sclerosis, or ALS, sometimes colloquially called after a famous baseball player, Lou Gehrig's disease. Mm-hmm. This data included the slowing of disease progression, showed improvements to patients' quality of life, and the ALS medical community is encouraged by these results.
Now, normally, what is the go-to treatment regimen for patients suffering from ALS, and what data does your company have that demonstrates efficacy so far?
Well, the challenges in developing effective drugs in ALS is many. There has been decades of attempts here. There are only two drugs that are approved in most regulatory markets, or in some regulatory markets worldwide, and most regulatory markets worldwide only have one drug that's approved. Now, neurodegenerative diseases share this common underlying mechanism, as I mentioned a minute ago, a decline in the cell's ability to produce energy. And when this happens, these energetic deficits lead to neuronal dysfunction and death. And as I noted also, this decline, though it occurs as a part of natural aging, it is amplified and exacerbated in a neurodegenerative disease like ALS. And the two drugs that have been approved in some markets over the past 20 years both have limited impact on function and survival. And so what we've got, very sadly for people who struggle daily with ALS, is it remains a devastating, a fatal disease 5 years from diagnosis. So what we're doing here at Clene is to use our science to harness the physical properties of elemental nanocrystals for therapeutic use.
Nanocrystals? I'm not familiar with that term.
Specifically, what we're doing is we're actually introducing an oral suspension that patients drink every morning. Mm-hmm. And these nanocrystals are built around a gold atom that serves as an energy reservoir, as it were, in the patient's central nervous system. system. And why this is relevant is because we are in clinical studies now, as I mentioned a minute ago, phase two just wrapped up. To date, CNM-Au8 has demonstrated no significant safety or tolerability concerns with over 200 plus patient years of safety data. And very critically, we are presently in a platform trial, the first of its kind ever implemented in ALS. CNM-Au8 was, in fact, one of the first assets selected in the ALS Healy platform trial, which is led by the Sean M. Healy and AMG Center for ALS at Massachusetts General Hospital, alongside more than 50 other centers of excellence in ALS, clinical centers of excellence in ALS across the country. And what a platform study is it's a trial designed with a shared placebo arm, and the intent is to reduce trial time, to reduce costs, increase patient participation in developing novel therapies for ALS. And we're very pleased to be involved in this program, where the study is rather expected to have top-line results around the summer of next year. So it will indeed be an exciting year for people who struggle with ALS in 2022 if the Healy ALS platform trial is successful.
Now, I understand that CNM-Au8 is also being considered for multiple sclerosis and possibly even Parkinson's disease. Tell me a little bit about this work and why this compound could also work on these conditions as well.
Indeed, beyond ALS, we're taking the same approach with other neurodegenerative diseases. Again, this shared lack of energy capacity is a challenge across many of these neurodegenerative diseases, including, as you note correctly, multiple sclerosis and Parkinson's. Now, we finished the phase two repair program in MS and Parkinson's patients earlier this fall. And what that program established was brain target engagement for CNM-Au8. That's another way of saying our drug, CNM-Au8, was shown to improve brain energy production and its utilization of key bioenergetic metabolites, namely ATP and NAD, bioenergetic metabolites the brain uses and requires for energy in both people with MS and Parkinson's. We wanted to show that our drug taken by mouth orally could get into the bloodstream, into the brain, and drive within the mitochondria these key energetic responses. Now, we are also involved concurrently in an ongoing phase two trial, Visionary MS, we call it. And the Visionary MS study is designed to evaluate the efficacy and the safety of CNM-Au8 in stable relapsing MS patients. And what we're looking specifically there to see if we could improve neurological function. And our primary endpoint is to see if we can return patients' contrast vision. Now, it might not be familiar with many of your listeners, but about 50% of multiple sclerosis patients suffer deficits in contrast vision. They have lesions on the optic nerve of their eye, and that prevents their ability to see gradations of light. And they cannot see gradations of gray and black and white. And we are literally attempting to see if we can improve their neurological function of their eye and to bring back their ability to see more clearly.
Is there any consideration or any difference in efficacy based on when in a person's life these symptoms present, ALS, MS, or Parkinson's? Some people develop maybe in their 30s or 40s. Others may not until their 60s or 70s.
We have not noted any differences in time of onset. There may be some differences in whether I'm early, mid, or late in my disease. We'll understand that difference during the clinical trial results when we were able to fully analyze all that data. But to your question of early onset when I'm in my 30s, 40s, 50s, 60s, we have patients across these decades that are involved in our studies, both middle-aged and older patients. So we've not noticed any specific aging differences to your question.
Well, is there anything that you'd like to add before you give us a website where we can learn more about your company?
Well, we're grateful that we've seen with Au8 already a demonstration of some early clinical benefits in our proof of concept studies. These are outcomes that are remarkably important to patients with ALS. There's evidence to suggest that we may have improved long-term outcomes. The visionary data, the Healy ALS data will all conclude over the course of the coming year or so. And if we are correct with this thesis that CNM-Au8 can provide neurological energy capacity back to a failing neurodegenerative system, then we will be able to show that we can improve, hopefully, neurological function for the first time in some of the most vexing neurodegenerative conditions that we wrestle with, in an aging population. So we're very hopeful that for the patient's sake, we can improve neurological function. Our website is www.clene.com and speaks more on that website about our approach.
Well, Rob, I thank you so much for joining us here on Health Professional Radio this morning. It's been a pleasure speaking with you.
Neil, it's a pleasure. Thank you for taking some time.
You've been listening to Health Professional Radio. I'm your host, Neil Howard, in conversation with Mr. Rob Etherington, CEO at Clene Nanomedicine. Audio copies of this program are available at hpr.fm and healthprofessionalradio.com.au. You can also subscribe to the podcast on iTunes, listen in, download at SoundCloud, and be sure and subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/healthprofessionalradio.